For those in line here today, the focus was more on getting a shot rather than which shot they would be getting. For health officials, it was a chance to refute skeptics who worry that the single-dose vaccine is somehow inferior to those that came before.
A little sore, but I feel really happy. I'm excited.
Martha Harding just got the single-dose Johnson & Johnson vaccine at City College of San Francisco. She was eligible through her work and says she didn't worry about which vaccine she got.
I think that for the getting only one dose, it was a good option for me. So no, I wasn't super concerned.
It's become an issue because the two-dose Pfizer and Moderna reported slightly higher overall efficacy. But experts say there's much more to it.
It has advantages that the other two vaccines don't have. You just need one shot. It has fewer side effects. And so there is an ability to provide this vaccine in places where we might not be able to supply the other two vaccines because it doesn't have to be frozen.
He notes that Johnson & Johnson was testing at the height of the surge as more challenging variants were emerging. His message, the best vaccine is anyone you can get.
The bottom line, though, is that all three vaccines are excellent, all three are safe, and all three prevent COVID death and hospitalization. That's what this is really all about.
It's all more critical because of the list of people who qualify for the vaccine expands Monday. Supply is still a concern, but that's expected to improve next month, and having three options will help. For people here today, the shot was another step forward.
Any vaccine is a great vaccine, and that's just kind of what it was. Is like it is a slow rollout, and so you know, having the Johnson & Johnson does alleviate that pressure.
In San Francisco, Christy Smith, NBC Bay Area News.